All praises, honor, thanks to Yahweh, while Yahweh shine and also double honors to the apostles and elders of Great Millstone, shall one to the 100 Israelites, which include Judah's children, so-called Negroes, Latinos, and Indians, who are oppressed together according to the book of Jeremiah 50:33, but to whom pertained the adoption, the giving of the law, the promises, the glory, and the covenants according to the book of Romans chapter 9. Opposed to the foreign teachings, which according to the book of Revelation 14:4 are represented defilement by foreign women, may the kingdom of everlasting life, joy, and secrets be revealed unto you, as the blood descendants of Jacob, whose name was later changed to Israel, according to the book of Genesis 32:28, scattered to the four winds of the earth, alright, as a people, of course, first. And we have many scriptures, alright, on the topic of this so-called UFOs, which are IFOs, because we can identify them, alright, opposed to the heathen, basically. For example, Zechariah 5:1, then I turned and I lifted up my eyes, and behold, a flying roll, alright. And this is my new favorite video, alright, and we will watch it, and then we start, alright. Check this out, man, alright. You know, imagine you drive around, alright. And, you know, suddenly a chariot appears, you know, pretty much out of nowhere. How it can always happen, alright, from behind, you know, over you, like in a, you know. Of course, they can have speeds that, you know, a car is not possible to reach, but, you know, and even Esau, his flying objects there, alright. But this is, you know, real slow, actually. Alright, but check it out, man, how chill this is, man, alright, how it rides, man, you know, a little bit on the right, a little bit on the left, you know, that's the chariots, man, alright, that's Yahweh's chariots, man, you see, check this out, man, now it comes, man. You see, like, you know, you know, here you have a time lapse, real quick, alright, check it out, man, it's my new favorite video, man, you know, I can't tell you how I love this video, man, I just love it, man, alright, this is sick, man, you know, and the lights and how it looks, you know, how flat it is, man, this is just sick, man, you know. My new favorite review. I got two other ones. Today I want to really give you a real quick overview, alright? And let's go on speed of 2, and now you see how fast it actually was. And it actually started to get slower, you know, after you could see it, you see? So it started to get slower, so it was actually more faster, you see? Check this out. Check it out. And now it comes a little bit faster, and then it gets slower, you see? You see? For me, it kind of stops a little bit, you know? We anyway don't understand how it works until we change pretty much, alright? And we have our own. Alright, check my video out, your own chariot in your own color and design. Alright. You know, of course they have more space in there, you know. Like it looks from the outside, you know. Alright, now we go a little bit, you know, on the slowest. You see? And the light, you know, to beam up the leg, pretty much. This is heavy, man, alright, you know, you have... They play with the lights a little bit, you know. Okay. And now we have this. Chariots plus laser beams. It's over for you. Alright. Okay. And this is re-upload. Check it out. There you go. Alright. Chariot in the sky. Just staying there. Alright. Without, you know, helicopter, you know, this spinning things, you know, or any kind of thing, man, just a chariot of Yahweh You know, like there's one animal that can fly and stay at one place at the same time. Our beautiful brother, Israelite Foreigner, I believe, he uploaded a video about this animal, and it you know, pretty much, let me get that real quick, you know, because we will fly over them scriptures real quick, so it's not a long video anyway. All right, so they have see, they have a flapping from the wings with kind of an eight form, you know. That's the only animal that can fly and stay at one point the whole time, basically, you know. Birds can do that, all right. And it's called, in Germany we called it it's difficult, you know, but how you say, I don't know, man. All right, but it's a bird basically, and they do this eight form, you know, with their wings, you know. Okay, this was the second one, and now we go to the third one. Maybe, you know, I remember the name of that animal. You know, we will go over the scripture, so, you know. Second Kings, of course, also, you see. Every chariot in its row, man, you know. There is not 1 meter too much on the right or on the left, man. All right, again, that's the power of Yahweh. Okay, this is not human made, okay. And this is some Iranian military shooting at the chariots, and they just, like you could see it in other videos, they pretty much play with you know, the air around them, because again, this is not human made, all right, and our power is not human limited, all right. You see, so they pretty much play around, you know. Nothing of Esau's, which is not even his, all right. It's all given by Yahweh. You know, he created everything, also the chariots, and he is using the chariots as a vehicle for the angels. You know, pretty much. He has no flying object that can do that, man. All right. 1 second, and you know, he would be pretty. It would be over with his vehicle, man. Okay. And let's go into the meaning first of the word chariot. All right. And this is the fake Jew Hebrew, but it means basically walk up. All right. And if we go into the info, it means to ride. You see. So who is riding on these chariots? The angels. On an animal or in a vehicle, causatively to place upon, for riding, or generally to dispatch, bring on horseback, carry, get on self up on horseback, put, cause to make, to ride in a chariot. All right, this is the blue letter Bible. Now we go into the, because this was really the root word, kan, so this is the word what you will see in the Hebrew there. In the fake Jew Hebrew, which is, you see, this is the root word which we will have in the King James, that is. And it means basically the same, wagon, okay? Wagon, recap, a vehicle by implication, a team by extension, cavalry by analogy, a rider, the upper millstone, chariot, upper millstone, multitude from the margin, wagon, all right? Or wagon, or how you say in English, okay? You see, and we will start with Psalms 68 and 17. The chariots of Elohim, which means God in the English, are 20,000, even thousands of angels. The Lord, whose name is Yahweh in the Hebrew, is among them, as in Sinai, in the holy place. So these chariots were always around us, and they were always with the Israelites, with his one and only chosen people. Psalm 68 and 4. Sing unto God, sing praises to his name, extol him that rideth upon the heavens, that rideth upon the heavens by his name, Yah, and rejoice before him. Alright, Yahweh begins with Yah pretty much, alright, if you wanted to. Jeremiah 4 and 13. Behold, he shall come up as clouds, you see, because they're always pretty much, you know, described also as clouds, alright? Because pretty much you can't say UFO or IFO, alright, if you don't have these terms in the ancient days, alright? And his chariots shall be as a whirlwind, his horses are swifter than eagles, you see? Woe unto us, destruction unto us, basically, for we are spoiled. O Yerushalayim, Yerushalayim, alright, wash thine heart from wickedness, that thou mayest be saved. How long shall thy vain doors lodge within thee? Alright, this is talking about the two doors. 1 Chronicles 28 and 18. And for the altar of incense we find gold by wage, and gold for the pattern of the chariot of the cherubims that spread out their wings and covered the ark of the covenant of the Lord. Psalms 104, verse 3 to 5. Who layeth the beams of his chambers in the waters, who maketh the clouds, who maketh the clouds his chariot, who maketh the clouds his chariot, you see, who walketh upon the wings of the wind. And I will show you some pictures of the site where I got the scriptures also from, and it's called realhebrewisraelites.com, and you will see many pictures with actually the clouds in a form of these chariots. So of course they basically hide sometimes. It's not like they have to hide or they even want to hide, but again, alright, if the world, every last one of them, would know that these chariots are actually here, and they would show themselves like they could, like Yahweh could do it, for what is not the time right now, pretty much these people would bug out, alright? They already bug out, okay? Who walk upon the wings of the wind, alright? So it's just perfect, you know, of course, the group with the one and only true gospel, the great millstone, the elders and apostles, go all the way down to the so-called Mexicans and the younger brothers, alright? We got the truth, and we also proclaim these chariots as a weapon from Yahweh, Baruch Hashem, Yahweh Shai, and the vehicles of the angels, and people who want to know these things, they will go to our videos and to our camps and so on, and they will see it. But it's not right now the case and the time to pretty much reveal that to everybody, alright? Because even when it's out there and it's actually proven, and it's actually public, alright, the information, not everybody knows it, you see? Who worketh upon the wings of the wind, who maketh his angels spirits, his ministers a flaming fire, who laid the foundations of the earth, that it should not be removed forever. Alright, okay. So the earth will be here forever, but, okay, this world time, there's a greater blessing to come, and that's Jacob's blessing. The portion of Jacob is not like them. 2 Kings 6 and 12 and 17. 2:17. And one of his servants said, None, my lord, O king, but Elisha, the prophet that is in Israel, telleth the king of Israel the words that thou speakest in thy bedchamber. And he said, Go and spy where he is, that I may send and fetch him. And it was told him, saying, Behold, he is in Dothan. Therefore sent he thither horses and chariots and a great host, and they came by night and compassed the city about. And when the servant of the man of God was risen early and gone forth, behold, an host compassed the city both with horses and chariots. And the servant said unto him, Alas, my master, how shall we do? And he answered, Fear not, for they that be with us are more than they that be with them. Alright, because he saw them chariots, alright, not these chariots with the horses, okay, there are different words in the Hebrew, different words. If you read over it with the correct wisdom of the scriptures as a Hebrew Israelite in the truth, alright. And Elisha prayed and said, Lord, I pray thee, open his eyes, that he may see. And the Lord opened the eyes of the young man, and he saw, and behold, the mountain was full of horses and chariots of fire round about Elisha. Alright, So he saw that ultimate level of technology pretty much arrived everywhere, man. Arrived, which the other people that were around them could not see. Alright? Alright. Isaiah 31 and 3 to 5. Now the Egyptians, which is actually all the hidden nations together right now, this moment, this very day, especially Esau, the cave dweller baseman, who is actually ruling right now. These are the Egyptians in the modern day, are men. They are human. They are men and not God. And their horses are flesh and not spirit. So basically, the angels, I believe, even travel with these chariots with their mind, alright? So they don't have to use, some stupid, bottoms, alright? On the cockpit, nah, man, alright? That's human stuff, alright? So as the elect will not use bottoms when they about to move their chariot in the kingdom, which is called the kingdom of God, to these heathen nations. When the Lord stretched out his hand, both he who helps will fall, and he who is helped will fall down, they all will perish together. Verse 4. For thus the Lord has spoken to me, as a lion roars and a young lion over his prey. When a multitude of shepherds is summoned against him, he will not be afraid of their voice, nor be disturbed by their noise. So the Lord of hosts will come down to fight for Mount Zion and for its hill, like birds flying. How do birds fly? They fly in the sky, all right? They fly in the sky, all right? And they do it by nature, just like the chariots, all right? They fly by nature. The angels fly by nature. Yahweh controls these chariots, all right, with his right hand of righteousness, all right? So will the Lord of hosts defend Jerusalem, all right? And that's talking about the chariots, the IFOs. Defending, he will also deliver it. Passing over, he will preserve it. Now we go to Isaiah 66 and 50 to 60. For behold, the Lord will come with fire and with his chariots like a whirlwind, to render his anger with fury and his rebuke with fire, with flames of fire. For by fire and by his sword will the Lord plead with all flesh, and the slain of the Lord shall be many. Isaiah 66 and 20. And they shall bring all your brethren for an offering unto the Lord out of all nations upon horses, and in chariots, and in litters, and upon mules, and upon swift beasts, to my holy mountain Jerusalem, said the Lord, as the children of Israel bring an offering in a clean vessel into the house of the Lord. Now we go to 2 Kings. This is kind of like a little bit more. We have 12 verses here. 1 to 12. And it came to pass, when the Lord would take up Elijah into heaven by a whirlwind, that Elijah went with Elijah from Gilgal. And Elijah said unto Elijah, tarry here, I pray thee, for the Lord hath sent me to Bethel. And Elisha said unto him, as the Lord liveth, and as thy soul liveth, I will not leave thee. So they went down to Bethel, and the sons of the prophets that were at Bethel came forth to Elijah, and said unto him, knowest thou that the Lord will take away thy master from thy head today? And he said, yeah, I know it. Hold ye your peace. And Elijah said unto him, Elijah, tarry here. I pray thee, for the Lord hath sent me to Jericho, Jericho, whatever. And he said, as the Lord liveth, and as thy soul liveth, I will not leave thee. So they came to Jericho. And the sons of the prophets that were at Jericho came to Elijah, and said unto him, knowest thou that the Lord will take away thy master from thy head today? And he answered, yeah, I know it. Hold ye your peace. And Elijah said unto him, tarry, I pray thee, hear, for the Lord hath sent me to Jordan. And he said, as the Lord liveth, as thy soul liveth, I will not leave thee. And they too went on. And 50 men of the sons that of the prophets went and stood to view afar off, and they too stood by Jordan. And Elijah took his mantle, and wrapped it together and smote the waters, and they were divided hither and hither, at hither, so that they two went over on dry ground. And it came to pass, when they were gone over, that Elijah said unto Elijah, Ask what I shall do for thee, before I be taken away from thee. And Elijah said, I pray thee, let a double portion of thy spirit be upon me. And he said, Thou hast asked a hard thing. Nevertheless, if thou see me, when I am taken from thee, it shall be so unto thee. But if not, it shall not be so. And it came to pass, as they still went on and talked, that behold, there appeared a chariot of fire and horses of fire, and parted them both asunder, and Elijah went up by a whirlwind into heaven. All right. So, of course, okay, they can appear as whirlwind, even just a wind, all right, clouds, you know, fire, all right. It's all in, man, with Yahweh, Baruch Hashem, Yahweh Shai, all right. Not to mention, pretty much also, you know, that nothing is impossible also. Okay, and Elijah saw it, and he cried, my father, the chariot of Israel, and the horsemen thereof, and he saw him no more. And he took hold of his own clothes and rent them into pieces. You see, this is heavy, man. All right, what he saw, man. All right, he was just, you know, like today, you know, if you're Hebrew Israelite, all right, and you see a chariot coming for you in these last days, man. All right, you will basically, all right, of course, you don't want to destroy your T-shirt, all right, because most likely. You will see other Israelites on the chariot, alright, so you don't want to be naked, even when it's only your belly, man, alright, amen, okay, so, but you will be pretty much, you know, in another spirit, pretty much, okay, and this is the site, of course, you can check it out on your own, alright, if you want to read more, because this video is already long. There has been much conjecture and conversation about the validity or truth of so-called UFOs, unidentified flying objects, since the beginning of time. However, since the 1950s or so, with science fiction or movies and tales of television and radio shows, they have made UFOs seem as if they were or are fiction and are fairy tale. Nevertheless, when we look back to time, there was a common belief of the so-called UFOs, and they were documented through art and writing since the beginning. Only as of late have they been fairy-talized and written off to be untrue. All right, and here you have some pictures. All right, and I will scroll real quick. Okay, in ancient hieroglyphs, pictures of so-called UFOs are commonly depicted, and also even helicopter-looking flying vehicles, the planes and ships on the pyramid caves and stone walls and all over the earth. Okay, here we go. These are the angels. Most likely, alright. You have the scriptures talking about there was one that was taller than the other ones, and this is basically our shine. Okay, check this out, man. Okay, tell me what this is. Okay. Okay, these are some scriptures, of course. Here, alright. Second Esdras. Okay, because I will read the black writings here, but we must look to the scriptures to see what the Bible says. Precept upon precept, precept upon precept. And take its words over modern day scoffers. First things first is common sense. The Most High Yahweh is the creator of all things. Okay? So even if you have scoffers talking about the chariots are evil or the so-called UFOs are evil, it doesn't matter because he is creating everything. You see? The Most High created all things. He is the grand architect. He ordained all knowledge and ordered all the pending of it to all mankind, to the angels, alright, and you have even unbelievers pretty much knowing that these vehicles are actually true, alright, and the men of the Lord, the Hebrew Israelites, the sons of the Most High, there is nothing new under the sun, not even airplanes, phones, televisions, everything was thought of in the beginning. Okay, there is nothing new under the sun, even airplanes. Why do people think that their technology is better than the Most High's? That's just stupid, alright, but they have to know it by death and pain. That is preposterous. His chariots are massive and innumerable, alright, so you can't even build that much flying objects, and we went already to the scripture, thousands upon thousands, I believe, alright, in Psalm 68, alright, okay, and also innumerable, so you can't even create how much he has actually, alright, somewhere in space. And he even created out of nothing, man. So, you know, what you wanna do, you know? In the Bible, he calls them chariots, clouds, whirlwinds, flying walls, horses, and cherubims. He also describes them in great detail and often, however, it's often overlooked in modern-day false teachings of the Bible. That's why we have, the doctrine which is not defiled by foreign women, as we said in an intro. So we went already to the definition of the word, and these are the other pictures, alright? Here you go. Check this out, man. Alright, you know, this was kind of interesting to me also, you know, check this out. Okay. In ancient art and hieroglyphs are spacecraft and drawings of chariots since the time of the Egyptian pyramids and ever since then. Okay. Esau doesn't even know how to build these ancient pyramids, which are, you know, still here today. The chariots of the Most High has been seen all over the world, and many cultures have documented them and has depicted them for perpetuity. All right. Check this out, man. You know, you have basically so-called wannabe technology, you know, human-based technology, you know. And they don't even can build with this modern-day so-called possibilities what the Egyptians built in the ancient times, okay. Of course, you have the vision of Ezekiel, but we will not go into that. Alright, it's just special for itself, man. Alright, I made a video very often about that, man. Alright, also when it's about the cherubim, man. Okay, check my video out. Michael is coming down. Alright, power of angels, cherubim, seraphim, etc. Alright, so we will go on here. So maybe these are the Indians, man. I don't know. Alright, but it looks kind of. Not just a little bit Asian also, you know, other Indian Asian, I don't know, man, but they painted this, man, alright, so of course the chariots were everywhere on the earth, just as we are scattered everywhere on the earth, man, we just like the sand of the sea, man, alright, so we go on. Okay, you have, for example, a Chinese looking man that is called the dragon, alright, nah, man, he's called you know, this Kung Fu guy, what's his name? You may know it, okay, this fighter guy there. So we will go on here. Alright, this is of course the Edomite woman, alright, and they, one way they painted over it, or the other way, it was built very, very late, alright. Or painted very, very late, okay. Here you have a coin with what looks like a chariot to me. Alright. So this could be also a chariot here on this photo. This is also an Edomite fantasy. Alright. Because Yahushai does not look like an Edomite. But here you got a chariot. Alright. So they painted most likely over it. There's also some chariots. Okay, and there was one other video that was about a chariot, pretty much. Alright, check out this man with this with the lights behind it, you know, or next to it, where a chariot actually is pointing a laser on a missile or on a weapon. Alright, a flying weapon. Alright, you could see it actually changing the position from where it's firing. Alright, while this weapon was actually flying, the chariot just moved around like, you know, like it's like there is no air, like there is no speed, or you know, you see? So, you know, these people don't know, man. Okay, this will be strange. Amazing, but also very fearful what they have to witness in these last days, because You know, I just say it like that. You know, still to this point, you don't know who we are. Okay. So check out this man. These are the clouds, you know. Check out the form, man. Alright. Check out the form, alright. UFO Cloud filmed in Russia, February 2012. This is some dark chariot here, you know, in another shape, pretty much. Three-cornered, alright. Here you have many lights on one chariot. You know, it looks like it has wings, pretty much, on its outside. You have a weird little one, but it's zoomed in, you know. You have the military often, pretty much, you know, seeing objects from far away, you know. You have the lights again, you know. Crowds gathered together at the strange lights that hovered. I can read that, but Stafford for 30 minutes. Okay, 30 minutes. I brought an article out not so long ago about Pennsylvania. Seems to be the place where they have the most sightings. All right, checked it out if you want. All right, I don't know how, you know, where it is, you know. Just go on my videos page and you may will see it if you have the patience to watch over the videos till you see it. Okay, and this is how it will look. Okay, maybe, alright, because it can look like even one fathership and more ships at the same time, but it can also be one fathership and that's it, alright. There can even be brothers that have their own chariot, pretty much, when the deliverances come. We don't know, alright. You don't even know if we survive or not, alright. But we know that we have the truth, alright, and this is one big part of it, man. Alright, and with that, all praises to Yahweh, Ba'asham, Yahweh Shai, Ba'asham, HaKadosh, all praises to Yahweh. Alright, to his son, Yahweh Shai. Okay, and double honors to the elders and apostles of the minister.